Oh my god, so much happened this episode. Oh my god, where do I even start? Where do I start? Probably from the beginning. That's where most people start, right? But there's so much that happened this episode. I'm so excited. So starting from the beginning, we see our main protagonist, Fujita Kun. He is dancing the basic waltz with his teacher, the female one. And he's being instructed on what to do. So they've obviously been practicing a lot and teaching a lot of the basic moves and turns and things. And he actually completes it this time without like stumbling or whatever. When he's done, everyone like cheers and it's like, yeah, you finally got the basic waltz down, yeah. And then the blonde guy, I don't know, I'm sorry, I don't remember her name as well, but the blonde guy is like, no, he was like a dog waltzing and stuff. And then they all like jump in and start making fun of him. They call him like a deer, a baby deer and a monkey, and just start making fun of him and the fact that he can't really dance and he still looks awful even though he's, you know, mastered the basic waltz somewhat. And then we get a glimpse of his family life, which he lives with his dad and his oma. Is it Oma? His grandma. And he's like explaining what's happening with the sumo wrestling match on TV. It's so funny because his Oma is perv. She's like, I can imagine a big naked guy now. Like, he didn't need to know that. I'm pretty sure he didn't want to know that. I just, no, it's funny. And it goes into the next day where he goes to the competition with Hyota and the black haired girl. Again, I don't know her name, I'm sorry. Yeah. So it goes into the next day where they're competing. And he watches them do the Latin dances and he's just like blush. Oh, before that. They were in the locker room getting ready, and the blonde guy sees his rival, and they call him Gorilla. Like, they were all over with the animal name calling and stuff. But he kind of reminds me of, if you've ever seen Shimaneta, the guy who was low-key gay and like the main protagonist, him. Yeah, he kind of reminded me of him. Because I guess they're both kind of like gorillas or whatever, but yeah. And so they're in the locker room and he throws some insults at the gorilla, which is what we're gonna call him for the remainder of this review, Gorilla. And then he starts talking to Hyota-kun and the black-haired girl and telling him that they better win. But he grabs the girl's, like, dress. Like, it's a halter top dress with, like, strings attaching it at, like, this point and at this point. He just grabs it. And she has to, like, cover up like this. Like, bruh, that's not okay. It's her boobies all exposed to the world and ish. Like, and the one chick over here taking pictures and stuff. No, that's not okay. And MC got a nosebleed over here going on and stuff. Like, bruh, no. Moving on from that, they go on to the contest, and the first one up is the Latin dance, and we got some nice apps, I might add. You know, there's 10 out of 10 apps. And I thought we were gonna get some more dance animation from that, because we did get a little bit with that at the start, but then it just goes into like showing the faces again and stuff, and just, you know, but it was fine, you know, can't complain. Got some great Latin American apps going on there. It's never a bad thing. And MC is watching this. Fujita-kun is watching this, and he's like blushing and jittery, like he's shaking his leg because of how excited it got him. And I'm just like half expecting him to get a nosebleed. You know, it's great. And then he hears the basic waltz music playing, and he goes to the restroom so that he can do the waltz because he's having the urge to like dance. And it was just, yeah. But then he hears two people coming, and so he goes to hide in a stall, and he hears them bashing Hyoro-kun, like talking down about him and how he thinks that dance is just a game and all this other stuff. And he starts to get mad, and it's such a 180 from last week, because last week we saw he was, you know, gonna go off on Hyoro-kun for how he treated the black hair girl and for treating it like it was nothing and all this other stuff. But then he saw how serious he actually was about it, and so then he changed his attitude. And from that to this week, he's getting mad because other people are having the same mindset that he did last week, where like they really don't understand him and that he looks like he's not taking it seriously, and he's getting mad at them for having that mindset about him and the misconceptions that they have about him. But in the stall, he looks forward and he sees Hyoro-kun sitting down, and he's putting medical tape on his knee. Obviously, he's like, his knee is injured in some way, shape or form. And he's, you know, putting medical tape on it so that he can continue on with the competition and just deal with it later, right? But when he sees this, he exits the stall, and I thought he was gonna go off on them. He didn't do that. He just left. And then he goes back to the stadium or something. And then the blonde hair guy grabs him and takes him to the locker room. He starts going through Hyoda's stuff because the next competition is starting for the ballroom dancing, and Hyoda is nowhere to be found. More on that later. And he starts going through his stuff, and he finds the medical tape and tells Fujita-kun to go out onto the dance floor with the girl, with the black hair girl. And I'm just like, that's unexpected. Wow, what? Right? And then it cuts to a scene where Gorilla is standing at the top of the stairs, and Hyoro-kun is at the bottom of the stairs clutching his knee because Gorilla pushed him down the stairs. He pushed him down the stairs. Yeah, that's okay. So now I'm like, okay, so is this gonna like make his injury worse down the line, you know, because he was already injured. But if he gets more injured, like that might not heal properly, and he might not be able to dance again, like depending on the severity of the injury, like he might not be able to practice as often, might not be able to compete, you know, and it could affect his entire career as a dancer. Like, And I'm just like, wow. Like, I was expecting, like, a talk or something. I was not expecting Gorilla to push him down the motherfucking stairs and, like, injure him. Potentially, like, killing his career, essentially. Like, okay. So, moving on from that, Fujita-kun gets all did up to go ballroom dancing. And Black Hair Girl is like waiting for Hyoto-kun, like nobody, everybody's looking for him, they can't find him. They probably didn't check the stairs. Moving on. So everybody's looking for him, she's waiting for him, because the next competition is like about to start any minute. And then Blonde Hair Guy has Fujita-kun in tow, and it's like, he's here, go onto the stage. And she's like, yeah, he found him. And lo and behold, it's Fujita-kun. And Fujita-kun has stage fright. Which I can understand. Like, this is so sudden. You aren't prepared for this. You don't know what to do. Everybody was just bashing on you for how horrible your waltz was. And now you have to ballroom dance in front of tons of people. Yeah, I would have stage fright too. And so, the Black Hair Girl was just like, come on, I'm here with you, we're gonna start dancing now. And then so, he starts doing Hyoto-kun's routine. He starts doing his routine with his partner, I might add. Mm-hmm. And then he like forgets some, and then starts making his own stuff up, like he starts adding things that he's seen in and just doing basics and just making up it up as he goes along. They're like pointing out the different routines that he's grabbing pieces from and stuff, and the fact that he's smiling about it. And the Black Hair Girl is just like, this dance is a mess, like it's a mess, but he's still making me dance. She's following and keeping up and everything. And he's smiling. And Hyoto-kun finally, gets up and makes his way to the competition scene and sees Fujita-kun smiling. He sees Fujita-kun smiling and he like gets mad. And then by the end of the ballroom dance competition, Fujita-kun and the Black Hair Girl, they fall because he trips over the hem of his pants because they're too long. He trips over his pants. Oh. And he just screams that he's sorry. And I'm just like, that was possibly the wrong time to do that. But, he's not a professional. He doesn't know that stuff. He sees Hyoto-kun, he's like, you're finally here, the tango is up next, I hope you do well. Hyoto-kun just like shuts that down. He goes up to him, grabs him, and it's just like, give it back. And that's how the episode ends. What? Oh god, I want to know what he meant by that, because did he used to smile? Did he used to enjoy dancing and he doesn't anymore, which is why he's not serious about it anymore? I mean, just, I'm excited to see what he means by that and where this takes us. Oh, but I really do hope Gorilla gets freaking disqualified for what he did to Hyoto-kun, because that is grounds for disqualification, I'm pretty sure. Talking about, oh, I think I'm gonna get first place this year. Like, after what you did? Wouldn't be so sure about that. Anyway, my next video will be my response/review of the final chapter of Fairy Tail. So,